everybody. Welcome to our channel, Living in Richmond, Virginia, where we show you exactly what it's like to live, work, eat, and play right here in RVA.
In this video, we're going to show you five different neighborhoods, all within Short Pump, where you can buy a home for under $400,000.
We will tell you everything you need to know about these neighborhoods. The last one is our favorite and has what we think is the best location, so be sure to stay to the end.
If this is your first time to our channel, welcome. I'm Taylor Jefferson.
And I'm Sarah Jefferson.
And we own and operate Jefferson Grove Real Estate. We've helped lots of families relocate to Richmond. And if you're thinking about doing the same, be sure to download our free Richmond Relocation Guide.
It's full of useful information all about Richmond and the surrounding areas.
The link is in the comments below and on our banner image. If you haven't done so already, you have to subscribe to our channel because every week we'll be posting new videos all about living in Richmond, including more neighborhood tours just like this one, fun things to do in RVA, and more.
Now, with all that being said, let's dive into today's video. We just made a video about neighborhoods in Midlothian for under $350,000. So why did we choose $400,000 for this video? Well, the average home in Richmond now costs $367,000, but Short Pump is more expensive than average. $350,000 doesn't get you what it used to get you in Short Pump. So out of necessity, we upped the budget to $400,000. Something to keep in mind when we talk about price in our videos is that it's just a momentary glimpse in time and prices change, but overall the market moves as a whole. So it's still all relative, and the neighborhoods mentioned today should remain some of the most affordable in the Short Pump area. We haven't covered any of these neighborhoods yet, so all of this information will be new. But we have done a lot of videos all about Short Pump, so be sure to check those out to learn more about the area.
We're going to start with the most affordable neighborhood mentioned in this video today, which is Tuckahoe Village. This neighborhood is located along the southern part of Lauderdale Drive near Patterson Avenue. There's a total of 486 homes here, and I bet this neighborhood will continue to see home prices appreciate over time, as this is one of the most affordable ways to get a nice home in the Short Pump area. These houses are on the older side as they were built between 1963 and 1971. Given the year built, you'll find lots of ranchers and tri-levels with the size range from 1,300 square feet to 2,700 square feet, but the average home here is about 2,000 square feet with 3 to 4 bedrooms and 1.5 to 2.5 bathrooms. Expect to pay somewhere close to $305,000 on average, with the low end in the mid-200s up to the high-300s. A nice bonus to this area is that there's a shopping center with a food line just a minute away, which is definitely a huge convenience win. The school systems here are Carver Elementary, Quiaquison Middle, and Godwin High School.
Next, we are headed further northeast to the Rainbrook neighborhood, which is located right off Gaskins Road. This is pretty much the eastern limit geographically, where you can say a neighborhood is still within Short Pump. This is a smaller neighborhood with only 100 homes built from 1977 to 79. There are lots of split foyer homes and tri-levels with a few colonials scattered about. They range in size from 1,500 to 2,900 square feet with an average of 2,300. It's a little bit more expensive here than in Tuckahoe Village with an average price of $321,000 in Rainbrook. Since there are a lot of split foyer style homes, they really packed in more rooms with that style floor plan. Expect to find homes with 3 to 5 bedrooms and 2.5 to 3.5 bathrooms. Two things you should be aware of about this neighborhood. One, the school systems here are not your usual Short Pump schools. They're schools from areas further east with Pemberton Elementary, Quiaquison Middle, and Freeman High School. Two, there isn't a stoplight for turning into the neighborhood. So if you're headed south on Gaskins coming home, you'll have to take an unprotected left turn, which can take a little bit of time during rush hour.
The Keswick neighborhood is next. This is a neighborhood of 120 homes located off of Church Road and bordered by John Rolfe Parkway. The homes are mostly vinyl-sided two-story colonials with a 1 to 2 car garage. Again, not a lot of variation. They were all built between 1995 and the year 2000. Something to keep in mind given the age of these homes is whether or not the roof and HVAC have been replaced, because if not, they would be at the end of the expected lifespan. House sizes range from 1,600 square feet up to 3,100 square feet, with prices from the high 300s to the mid 400s, with an average sold price of $395,000. So it won't be long until the prices are all above the $400,000 mark. These houses have 4 to 5 bedrooms with 2.5 to 3.5 bathrooms. What we love about this neighborhood is that you have great schools and a great location. You are literally 5 minutes from anything and everything you could need. There are lots of nearby grocery stores, restaurants, gyms, and shopping. The school systems are Gayton Elementary, Pocahontas Middle, and Godwin High.
This next neighborhood also benefits the same from its location. Ridgefield is a neighborhood located off of Gayton Road and Ridgefield Parkway. Less than a mile away, there's a shopping center with a Publix grocery store and a really nice YMCA. This is an 80s neighborhood full of lots of single-level contemporary homes, and then on the other streets, two-story colonials. It's crazy because there is an invisible line where all of a sudden there aren't any more contemporary-style homes and everything's now a colonial. There are 160 homes in total, with prices ranging from the high 200s to the low 400s, with an average of 345. The average house is 3 to 4 bedrooms with 2,000 square feet, but the lower limit of that range is on the smaller side with 1,200 square feet and 2,700 on the high side. Almost all of the contemporary ranches have cedar siding, which is a pretty high maintenance product, so that's definitely something to be aware of. The school systems are Gayton Elementary, Pocahontas Middle, and Godwin High School.
The last neighborhood has what we think is the best location of all of them today. Gayton Station is located right off of Gayton Road to the west, and it's directly south of Greengate and West Broad Street. Greengate has some great restaurants, and across the street is a shopping center with the Short Pump Wegmans and Cabela's. Plus, you are super close to the Short Pump Mall, and this particular part of West Broad Street is a really easy drive to the highway exit for 288. There are 172 houses here, all built between 1990 and 1996. Not every home in this neighborhood will be below the 400K mark, but the average is 374,000, with a range from the mid-300s to the low 400s. They vary in size from 1,500 square feet to 2,400 square feet, with the average being right around 2,000. Almost all of them are two-story colonials, and a good amount have at least a one-car garage. Here's the kicker about this neighborhood. The curb appeal is hit and miss. Some yards are beautiful and well-manicured. Others look like the developer nuked the earth and forgot to give the yard any character. So it doesn't have the uniform, beautiful curb appeal that some of the older neighborhoods in Short Pump have, but overall it's still pretty and you can always fix curb appeal. The school systems here are Knuckles Farm Elementary, Short Pump Middle, and Deep Run High.
So there you have it, 5 affordable neighborhoods all within Short Pump. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you had a favorite, leave us a comment and let us know.
We have so many more great videos coming up, so be sure to subscribe to our channel. And if you're thinking about moving to Richmond, be sure to hit us up. We can make your move stress-free and easy. Thanks for being here with us today. We'll see you next time.
Thank you.